All right. If we're at on point in our flagging station, what can affect where we stand?
Sight distance.
Yeah, absolutely. What do we need to be able to see? Yeah, we need to be able to see what's coming down the road, right? Absolutely. What can affect how wide the shoulder is, for one, right? That's a lot. There's lots of different things. There's location of the work. We talk about being a significant distance away, which is a minimum of what? Minimum of 100. What's desirable?
200 to 300 feet.
Thank you very much. We're getting this. Visibility of approaching traffic. How far do we want to be able to see? Far as we can. Yeah, it's a good answer. I like that answer. What's the 500 feet? Why 500 feet?
Alertness.
Yeah, I like that. It's a good one. Why 500 feet? Why is 500 feet a magic number?
Make
the good decisions. Yeah. All right. I like to know why. We'll talk about that. So if we got operation going on here, if this work is going on here, if Tony's got his crew and we're working right in the middle of this here, if all this work's going on here, where do I need to be from the work? How far away from the work do I need to be?
200 to 300 feet.
200 to 300 feet desirable, but a minimum of
100.
Minimum of 100 feet. Very good. From that point, I'm here. So how far do I need to be able to see? Far as you can, but a minimum of how far?
500 feet.
500 feet visibility. Where should I stand? Should I stand, if this is my roadway, let me say this. If this is my roadway, this is my double yellow line or whatever, where should I stand? Should I stand here so I can kind of see things going on? This is the active lane of traffic right here, right? This is the other lane here. Where should I stand? Kind of like right in here, just in here, here, right in here, right? Or actually, far over here as I can, right? No, we need to stand here, right? We don't ever want to be here, right? Never. We don't ever want to be here. And we'll talk about, bless you, we'll talk about that in a little bit. What happens when we get across here?
Danger,
absolutely. What's going on right here? Yeah, this is an active lane of traffic, even though we're flagging, right? This, just because I have this does not make me what? Does not make me Superman, right? No, it does not make me Superman. So even if I'm flagging, if they're not going to stop, standing right here is not going to make them stop any quicker, is it? No, so we are always flag from across the white line. We never flag from anywhere inside of this. Yes?
What about some of the roads that the white line is there and then it drops off? What would you do in those situations?
I realize that there are roadways that are less than perfect. My recommendation is do your best to plan and try to find a location that is more conducive to a flagger station that at least has a semblance of some kind of shoulder somewhere that has at least a place where you can stand. And I know that there's places that you may not have any of that stuff. And in situations like that, sometimes you have to back up and punt. I don't know. I get it. I mean, I understand. I mean, Jeff, you've probably seen places like that. They're just like, hey, there ain't nothing. We have to go 2 miles. We don't find anything. I get it. I mean, I know that there's some places that you may not find anything. I don't know. And I don't have the answer for that. But sometimes we just do the best we can do and be as safe as possible. So there may be different things that we can do. We've looked at using portable rumble strips, and we'll talk about that some today too, some other things that we can use. But in that case, we need to be extra vigilant and extra on alert and have some kind of, have an escape route. We'll talk about that as well. But we want to do our best to stay over here as much as humanly possible. Because the second we're here, the more danger that we're in. I mean, it is what it is. So we need to be as cautious as humanly possible, because when we step over here, we're in the danger zone. I mean, that's really what it boils down to. All right, any questions on that?
Wayne, can I make a comment?
Absolutely.
I came in late, guys. I'm Jay Norris. I work in Nashville in safety division. Work with Wayne. But I want to let you know that we had a flagger hit in Fayette County will be reaching for, I guess it's the second week of July. And there were two things he was doing. Can you guess where he was standing?
On the center line.
He was on the center line. In which way was he turned?
Wrong way.
His back was to track. So if we, I don't know what the test looks like, but I'm we're serious, is that those are the two things you have to walk out of here today with. You cannot turn your back on traffic, and you cannot stay in the front. I mean, that is, I mean, that does the highest critical things we need to learn today. It's serious. You guys know better than I do, is that traffic is the main issue. So we need to keep that in mind, and we need to approach traffic that way, that they're not. So, sorry to interrupt.
No, that's good stuff. It's easy. Here's what I get and understand. So we have, not all of our routes have 30,000 ADT on them. And a lot of our routes where we flag, I know, for instance, we were testing our rumble strips was in Hancock County. And it was like, we want to test this new product, and it's like maybe 300 ADT. So what happens a lot of times, and y'all have been on these jobs where it's a flagging operation and you're here, and it's easier, in a sense, it's easier to flag when it's busy to some degree, because you're staying active, there's a lot of cars coming and going. But what happens when there's no cars? What happens? Because, yeah, well, your mind wanders, and then where's all the fun stuff at? The fun stuff is here, right? The fun stuff is behind you. I mean, I get it. I mean, I understand it, because the crew's working down here, and if you're getting a car every 7 to 10 minutes, and there's some routes that's like that. I mean, it just is what it is. I mean, there's some routes you may get a car every 7 to 10 minutes. And so if you get in the car every 7 to 10 minutes, where does your attention wane to? Your attention kind of goes this way, right? If you get in the car every 7 to 10 minutes, and you're not paying it much attention this way, and cars are much quieter, it ain't like, they all don't have, you know, headers and, you know, dual exhausts and all that stuff like that. Maybe all in Hancock County, I don't know. But it's different. Not, some of them are much quieter, and they can sneak up on you. If you're not paying attention, and they're not paying attention, how easy for it is you sit here and say, man, he's good on that track hoe. And next thing you know, you're doing this number like this. And especially slope mowing and stuff like that. One of the guys, and it's a thousand wonders. It is a thousand wonders that the accident that happened, that I don't know if y'all in region 4, the I don't know if y'all saw the pictures on the TDOT Facebook site, the guy that came through and hit the tractor, knocked the entire back wheel off the tractor. The if I remember correctly, correct me if I'm wrong, John, the guy was standing in the middle of the roadway. Is that correct?
Yes.
Our flagger, he was in the middle of the roadway, and honestly, had he been standing anywhere else, it may have been even worse. I don't know. So, but we're not advocating they stand anywhere else. But he was standing here. He was watching this way. If I got the facts straight. But in any case, he wasn't paying attention. So it's easy for our attention to be drawn this way on a lot of our routes that don't have a lot of traffic. But who's the most important person? The flagger's the most important. And where's our attention need to go? I mean, it's hard to stay focused. But it's so important, your safety, because we know people are not paying attention. So it just takes a second for stuff like that to happen, and to get in a terrible scenario. On the shoulder, barricaded lane, visible to and facing traffic. That is super, super, super important. All right.